My story is pretty sad, but as I stand before you, it was to strip everything from take my clothes off, take my skin, and all I had was my spirit. All I was having is faith. That's all I can lean back on. And as you tell you my story, you'll understand. Now, this past weekend, I had an opportunity to go back home. I hadn't been home in maybe about 7 or 8 months. I drove back, and we had a reunion at the University of Michigan. So, myself, Ty Law, Tom Brady, Fab Five, some of you guys may know Fab Five. Know Fab Five? Yeah. Okay. We all sit there, and the whole time, this whole weekend, all we talked about was old memories. How do you remember, man? You remember this day? You remember when you did this? You remember that? And then I began to think, as I was driving back on 401, I said, you know what? We all live life off memories. And I thought about it. I said, you know, I'm no different. I said, I think everybody lives life off memories. Now, I'm going to take you to some of my memories, and as I talk about it, it's tough to go through my memories, but it helps me to talk about the things I've been through. The first memory I want to give you, and this is tough one, I'll never forget, I was 13 years old. My dad died when I was 2, so I never saw my dad. But all through this time, I never had a dad, a father, or a father figure in my life. So finally, my mom needed a new guy. He came into our house, and I never had a car. So when I grew up, my hood, I was poor. No, I'm sorry. I sometimes I remember eating beans, just eating bread sandwiches, but you know what, they gave me care. So when I sit there, this guy came into our house, it was cool, he bought some ice cream, he took me and my brother, the guy took him to the mall, and everything was cool. Until this one day, I hear his screams, loud screams. Ah! Abused my mom because she didn't want to kiss me. I was just one of these. That started from 13 all the way until I was 20. I'll never forget when he took my brother, he took a can, and he threw it and popped my brother in the eye. Almost lost the vision. Memories. I'll never forget when the time I was coming home and I got in the basement. I used to collect baseball cards. And I used to set the baseball cards up with some cups, and we used to take aluminum foil. Ball it up, I'm a piece of piss as a baseball bat. I would roll it on the ground. My brother would hit the ball. If I hit the cup, it would be out. If I caught it in the air, it would be out. We sit there, and just a week ago, my mom just got that bug. So, we hit the ball, it goes up, and I'm looking on the burners. I'm a little kid at the time. I pull up on the chair, and I'm looking, and I'm going to reach up and pull out. There's a credit card, an ID, a wallet, her check. Same thing that she had married. It just multiplied 5 days ago. Memories. That's all we live off of. So when I think about my memories I have, I always think about how do I leave when I leave? But when I leave, what kind of memory do I leave for myself? How do I treat people? Because that's what we all remember. When I leave this school, all I am is a memory. Hopefully you guys understand that whatever you leave for people, that's what they remember. I'll take you to another memory of mine. Now, this one here was social media that, as I talk about it, my lips tremble because I get so nervous about it. My brother was an opposite. I played sports, and that was what got me off the street. My brother loved the street life. He really enjoyed it, and that's all he wanted to do. But as a young kid, my mom always talked to me about choices. The choices you make today will mold you for the future. I was 7 years old, and I didn't understand that. You know, we were walking down the street, and she was looking at me. It's my neighborhood, the YBI was a gang that was always in my hood. They stood around the corner. We couldn't go down the street. Imagine living on this house right here. But I didn't know who lived on this house. I couldn't even see the park I lived on this street. I couldn't even play in that park. All I could do was walk to the left. Because my parents down there, y'all were beat up. I was getting hit with a baseball bat. They even got shot at me. So every time we would go, my mom would come off work, she would get off the work, she would come home, we would walk, and we would go to the left. This one particular day, my mom said, you know what, I'm tired of running from these guys. We walk to the right. I kind of got nervous. But I'm listening to my mom. I never forget, we walk down the street, we hold hands, as we approach this corner, these guys are hanging out in this corner. We looked up, my mom touched her hand a little bit tired, we walked across the street. I can hear these voices to this day. What's up, white lady? Hey, what you doing? My mom was out lying. Sitting there and talking to Pat. Hey, what's up? What's up, Pat? do? We walked by. My mom simply looked down at me and said, do you want to do this? I said, yeah. It was kids playing baseball. That was my first reception into baseball. Her exact words to me, the choices you make today will mold you for the future. I was 7 years old. Didn't know what that meant to that favorite day. November 13th, 1997. I got a call from my mom. Say, you remember those choices I talked about? I said, yeah, so your brother just got shot for you. So, man, what are you talking about? How did it happen? Well, when I walked out the front door, he jumped out the back door. 7 shots were ran into that car. 7 guys in the car. He was the only person to get shot. I look back and I think about it and reflect on my life now. Did that happen for a reason? Did it happen for this incident? I believe it happened for a purpose, because I said before you, knowing that somebody is going through the same thing y'all been through. Somebody that's been parents being abused, somebody that lost a family member, somebody that lost a brother. But I stand before you and let you know that you can make it through it. It's not about your reception into this world, it's about the direction. Once I found out the life of our relationship, I don't know anybody in here. But most of the time when I walk into the school, you know, we have a big banner that you know our house is here. And it's cool. But I remember walking here, nobody knows who I am. So you can sit and say, man, that dude just sat there. He showed love to me. Because that's all I have in life. It's my emotions, my feelings, my story. We all got a story. I want to leave with you guys that the memories you create today last a lifetime. How you treat people last a lifetime. But if you give one, it'll come back to you tenfold. So think about the memories that you need with each other. Because that's all we have in life. I'm no different than you. The only thing that makes me different than you is how I view my experiences. Yes, I've had a bad life. Nah, don't feel sorry for me. I want you to be proud of me because I stood up and said, understand that I'm giving back. Somebody in this crowd today is understanding where I'm coming from. Understand that it's about friends. It's about the relationship you have.